Considering all these hazards during pregnancy, how will you manage this case?
The principles for management are prevention of preterm labor, prevention of fetal trauma during labor, and good neonatal care. I will ask the patient to come for regular monthly checkups in first two trimester and every fortnight in third trimester. Requirement of iron, vitamins, proteins is increased compared to the singleton pregnancy, so I will give iron supplements from first trimester and also in puerperium. I will check her hemoglobin, urine, blood pressure, weight gain and height of uterus in every visit to detect abnormal course earliest. I will do ultrasonography to rule out fetal anomalies, placenta previa and hydramnios. Patient should be hospitalized after 32 weeks of pregnancy, given bed rest in head low position and uterine relaxants if required.
Why do you want to admit her in the 8th month?
In an attempt to prevent onset of premature labor.
How will you manage twin labor?
In the first stage, I will keep the patient lying down as opposed to single pregnancy to avoid premature rupture of membranes and cord collapse. I will confirm the position of fetuses and fetal heart sounds. I will keep ready a functioning intravenous line and blood transfusion and neonatal resuscitation care. In second stage, I will watch for cord prolapse, and at the time of delivery of head, I will give an episiotomy to avoid compression of premature fetal head. After delivery of first fetus, cord is clamped immediately to avoid excessive transfusion of blood to delivered fetus and exsanguination of second fetus. Methargine should not be given after delivery of first fetus. Now, I will auscultate the fetal heart sounds and confirm the presentation of the second fetus. Generally, uterine contractions return after 15 to 20 minutes. If not, I will start oxytocin drip of 2 units in 500 ml of 5% dextrose and do artificial rupture of membranes. If the baby lies transversely, then I will do internal podal version followed by breech extraction. If the lie is longitudinal, either vertex or breech, I will await spontaneous delivery, assisting to hasten the second stage. Third stage, though the placentae of twins are separate, both generally deliver after the delivery of second twin. I will avoid methargine till the delivery of the head of the second twin. I will watch for postpartum hemorrhage due to uterine overdistension and uterine inertia.
After delivery, how can you diagnose univobular and binovular twins?
In univobular twins, sex, blood group and RH of both babies are same and both are immunologically compatible with each other. Monoamniotic and monochorionic twins are always univobular.
How can you diagnose Siamese twins antenatally?
It is very rare condition, 1 in 50,000 to 1 in 5 lakhs. On X-ray or on ultrasound, conjoined twins shows continuous skin lining, same relative positions, face-to-face relation and same relative levels of both fetuses.
How do you deliver conjoined twins?
If diagnosed late in labor due to obstruction, destructive operation should be performed. If diagnosed antenatally and surgical facilities are available to separate conjoined twins, elective caesarean section can be done to save the child.
This is the end of the 6th clinic in obstetrics on twin pregnancy.